do you think this team will be feeling after that result?
Appreciate your time.
Welcome along then to the Belgian Grand Prix, the race that gave us the maiden victory for the Jordan team in 1998. And in the same team, the phenomenal debut of a young Michael Schumacher. There's always something special around one of the many corners of this fan favourite circuit. So here we are once again, ready to go racing through the Ardennes Forest. 4.35 miles of long straights, fast corners and massive elevation changes. It makes this not only one of the most exciting circuits on the calendar, but one that makes for some consistently high quality racing as well. Simply put it, there really is no place quite like Spa. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
But from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle. And the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The Finn starts from pole position. And P2 goes to Daniel Ricciardo. A strong showing from the Australian. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Gasly, Carlos Sainz, and Perez, Norris, Stroll, Matsushita, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Leclerc, Russell, Esteban Ocon, Moore, Vettel, Tsunoda, and Guan Yu Zhou, and Nicholas Latifi, Mick Schumacher, and Nikita Mazepin. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
Some wear on the MGUK. To manage this, we'll need to lower our ERS deployment mode.
Yes! Come on, boys!
Superb driving. That's the race win.
What a great race then, and what a magnificent victory here at the Belgium Grand Prix. Tell me, Ant, how did they manage to achieve this win?
I think we'll chalk this one up to a deft touch on the brake pedal. That's allowed them to challenge down the inside into the braking zones, and ultimately, if you do that often enough, you end up winning the race. It was great to watch as well though, wasn't it? Forget strategy, forget tyre management. Who doesn't love a good old-fashioned scrap?
Ferrari are at it again, an excellent performance at today's Grand Prix, and they're certainly a team that know what they're doing out there. So let's review the updated driver standings. Despite the best efforts of our championship leader, that lead has taken a bit of a knock today. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Moore. They fought so hard and had incredible pace at times, so I don't think anyone else did a better job today.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes moved to the top of the table. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to join us again as we continue to bring you the latest excitement in Formula One.
out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that. How are you feeling after that win? Well, looks like your luck has changed. Things went a lot better than last weekend, did... It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it? Great. Well, that's everything.